Back here at my favourite spot for a bit of whitebaiting. We got in late last night, set up a bit of a camp over there in the bushes. Whitebaiting is the kaupapa. Gonna shoot up here and pop the net in. And I'll run back to the camp, have some coffee, have some brekkie, get myself sorted, and get ready for an exciting day. So yeah, cheer. Nets are in. We'll see what happens. is the old man's setup today. So it's the old Southland sock net, two screens. You're allowed 3 meters of screens. That's the what the law requires. Some guys down here I've seen 9 meters of screen. Who am I to tell them?
Oh, good little shoal.
Yep, good little shoal. Okay. Yep. Can't beat that thing. Whitebait fritter for lunch whilst whitebaiting. Fuck, it's a hard life, eh?
Why doesn't it shake your stream? You know, like this doesn't do you all that, eh?
Yeah.
Why is that?
Oh, they got best cameras, mate. Stabilizing cameras.
Oh.
Right, I'll give you a bit of a walk through the camp. So this is an outside view. It's my boat over there in the trees. Your humble tarpaulin. This is the communal kitchen area. A little chill out area. Well, it could be another sleeping area if you'd like. Built it round with sand, so it's airtight. Take you over to the master bedroom. XO4. Navigator south tent. And here's my little bedroom. All over here. Alone, like ET. So this is the setup. This is the whitebaiter's dream. I'm going to smoke these fish soon, so I'll show you how they turn out when I'm cooking them. Smoked fish chowder. Ampua. Might have boiled mullet, puha, and spuds.
Mmm.
What do you reckon?
Mmm. Man.
Yeah.
The sauce that you make kurup and the chicken noodles.
It's got noodles in it.
Morning, team. 6 a.m. in the morning. Nets in. Let's go. Oh shit. Nothing in here, bro. We got a herring. Oh, another little herring. Woohoo! Bloody huge kingfish there. Big kingfish for breakfast. There's the old man over there putting the net in.
Pulled it in that way. Got a little kingfish. Go back to the camp and have some coffee, get ready, and white baiting is the kaupapa.
Net's in. So we're running two nets set up again today. I'll be fishing this big back net. The old fella's gonna fish the front net. Yeah, tide's not until this afternoon. High tide's at around 2:30, 3 o'clock today. So, you know, any 3 hours before, that's when we need to be in position. The problem with this spot right here is the kind of lack of current. So, for the most part, we're waiting until the turn of the tide, when the current comes back. That's when the whitebait are gonna push up quickly, in theory. Again, it's a nice reminder you can have everything in place. All the indicators can be in your favour, and you can still catch nothing. Yeah. There's a big shoal just on the inside of my marker. So you're going over the marker now, just on the inside. Another shoal just about to go over the inside of my marker.
A couple of shoals coming quick.
Yeah. Hey, you got a feature, right, guy? You were my big hit last time.
Yeah, videoed that one.
Yeah.
Man, open it up.
Whoa. Got about a pound of whitebait in here.
Yeah. From one lift.
Let's go for a mark. Well, you reckon, bro? Have a look at that beautiful sunset.
Oh, why do you do that?
What's that, flounder for brekkie?
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah. We missed another one that size too, it was too far out.
And he missed, I reckon that one was bigger. And then there was the eel that came right up, but I missed them.
Dang. Wouldn't it? Saturday morning. Raining. But you can't have a camp without a bit of rain, eh? So, all good. Have a coffee, have some brekkie, and back into it.
Oh, right.
Yeah, been sitting here for about 3 hours now and caught maybe one whitebait.
Fuck.
Patience is the name of the game, eh? Patience is something that I don't have.
Well, this is the last night. Gonna pack up the camp early tomorrow morning and head back to Wellington.
Fellas out there putting out the mullet net. One more night, see what happens tonight. Never know, we might catch a few mullet, maybe some herrings and some kahawa. Anyway, my friends, it's that time again. I'm gonna shut the vlog off there. I hope you enjoyed this video as much as I enjoyed making this video. I've had a fantastic time. It's been the best 5 days. My mind, body and soul is full. My cup is full. Anyways, appreciate you all. I hope wherever you are in the world that you're safe and happy. And I hope to see you down the road sometime soon. Kia ora.